do over a million plus in American television. Floyd will take this fight. This is a better fight for Floyd. It makes him more money. Right now, he's got to deal with the UFC and Dana White. Oh, he's acting like he's running shit. Dana White ain't running shit. Floyd Mayweather sits at the table. He is the king of that table. The reason why Dana White is out here running around is because he knows Floyd Mayweather is thinking about Wembley. Floyd Mayweather just seen what the UK is doing over there. Okay, these fans are showing up and they're dropping over $2,000 for these fight tickets. Cal Brook, are you ready? Cal Brook has 12 rounds. If he can win these next 12 rounds, he will get Floyd Mayweather at Wembley for the 50-0. There you go, Lee.
Okay.
I just thought of that.
That's not going to happen.
Oh my gosh. How can you not see that? Did you just see what Anthony Joshua
did? I'm just telling you.
You're telling me Cal Brook, Floyd Mayweather, Wembley Stadium for his 50-0 is not bringing 100,000 UK fans? It's hard to see it not. This is what we live for. This is the fights we want, right? We dream of. The UK has one of the best fighters in the world. America has the top fighter in the world, maybe top 10 all time. They're going to get it down in a stadium with 100,000 people are viewing. It's the fights we wait for. Look at McGregor and Mayweather. We all know what that is, okay? With this fight right here, this is real. This actually makes Floyd Mayweather tingle a little, okay? McGregor didn't. McGregor's a money grab. McGregor's the biggest bank robbery Floyd has ever done, and he's done a lot of them, okay? That's nothing. This fight right here is huge. 50-0, you go to Wembley and you beat their best guy, and we're all going to call Brooke number one. Let Brooke beat Spence.
Moving over to Vitaly Klitschko and Anthony Joshua. No surprise, we called it here. They're already in talks of having the rematch in fall. When I presented that to Andrew, he said, no.
I didn't say no, Lee. I'm saying there's rumors that the man don't want three defeats in a row to end his legacy. There's rumors that this defeat, the way he lost, is a good way to exit right now. And Lee, I also got to bring in the fact that anyone who followed that fight knew that Klitschko had trained his ass off. It's all he talked about. His experience, the training. Anthony Joshua was more of a muscle builder than he is a boxer. He did it all. He said it all to hype himself up, to hype up the fight. Put on a hell of a fight, but he lost, Lee. And not only did he lose, he got knocked out. And it was a bad knockout. That uppercut went around the world. So, I don't know. It might be true. Maybe three defeats is not the way you want to end. Is that the way you would want to end your legendary career?
Watched that tape, I'd see a guy who caught me lucky at the end.
Yeah, but he still caught him. And he caught him he caught him earlier in that fight, too, that really hurt him. And I get what you're saying. But maybe Klitschko knows that was the best he had, and Joshua has a little bit room to get better. And 6 months down the line or 5 months down the line, that kid's going to be better, and you're not going to be what you were 6 months before because you're already over the hill. All you can do is decline unless you take steroids. And you take steroids, everything's fine. But if he's on a natural run, the decline, there is no turning that back. So who knows? Because you know what I don't? Hearn has already been throwing out a few names like they already moved past. And I know they just released a story like 2 days ago about them signing for fall or talking for fall. But now he's brought up November. Now he's saying, I believe, what is it? Wembley can't do a fight in December. So they're talking about coming to Vegas. We'll see. Financially, that fight makes sense. But the timeline may not call for it. If they tell Vladimir, you can't fight Joshua at Wembley until next year because we're not doing December. We want one fight before that. He might not be sticking around for 2018. He might walk. So we will see.
They're talking, there are rumors circulating for the Canelo Triple G undercard. If it's true, we might actually have a competitive card. Lemieux versus Danny Jacobs.
Wow.
and Chocolito in a rematch against Ruben Sali Vali, the dude who basically beat the shit out of him.
What's that one again?
Chocolito.
In a rematch. The guy that beat
Rung Vasai.
Yeah, they can do anything with Chai. He's got two guys that owe him fights, or he owes them fights, however you want to put it. Yeah, they can Cuadras. He owes Cuadras a rematch too. So that's an excellent fight.
Plus, look, Jacobs and Lemieux, that's a triple card right now. You got pay-per-view money coming in on that.
It is. I don't know if Daniel Jacobs and Al Haymon will take that fight though.
They're saying it's done.
It's done.
Rumors circulating.
Wow. All right.
Rumors circulating as of today. That's being signed for the undercard.
Nice. Well, that's a good fight. I got Daniel Jacobs, a big time favorite though. Lemieux just shown me anything that would show that I can see him getting inside of Jacobs. Jacobs going to be on his toes. He's going to stick behind the jab, and that's going to be easy money for him. Oh, you know what? I forget. I'm sorry, people. All you're going to say he's going to get knocked out because of Pirog, but he went through G 12 rounds of that power. I don't see Lemieux knocking Jacobs out without it being you can't say lucky. Lemieux's a hell of a puncher. That's what he got, Lee. He's got a puncher's chance, but I got Jacobs 12-round decision. Easy. Easy money.
Photos and video have circulated. The Crusher is out in the woods getting ready for Ward Kovalev 2.
Scary fight.
I gotta be honest for Ward. I might have retired. I don't know if I'd give Kovalev a second shot.
Once again, is this going to be
a... Do you want a hungry Kovalev? Like, I think he was a confident Kovalev the first time. Okay? And that's how you caught him in his atypical game plan. But okay, now you're going to let Kovalev go back... And now he's hungry and pissed off.
Like, he lost his way. He lost his way in the first fight, Lee. When he knocked him down, what was it, second round?
Yeah.
The second, third round, he drops Andre with the right hand. He turns into a headhunter. He literally started thinking, when I hit him, he's going to go down. And he allowed
Not going to happen Ward, a second time.
It's not. If it's they're not. Smart.
It's a bad fight for Ward.
If they are smart. Now, this is another thing I got to bring up, and we'll talk about it more as the fight gets closer. But John David Jackson needs to really raise his game up in that corner, too. That man went blank. I don't know what it's like he froze under pressure, but he was not. Every time, if you guys watched that fight, when they are in his corner, Jackson isn't talking. And if he is, it's more motivation than it was directions or you know, different things. He's telling them, giving them advice on how to get around Andre Ward's offense. This fight is yes, this is the most anticipated rematch this year. This is the fight.
I know, and sadly, but I would what's tell he going to do, a $500,000 buys this time?
Yeah, I know. I don't know what it's going to do. And I haven't seen Roc Nation doing a damn thing. I'm on social media every day.
I'll say it again. It was the fight of the year last year. No doubt in my mind.
Main event. No, that was this year, Lee.
I mean this year, yeah. No, it wasn't. It was last year.
Okay. All right. My bad.
Jesus Christ. Now you had me thinking about it. I'm like, what month are we in? Shit, no.
It was the end of the... Yeah, it was. Okay. Main events doing a way better job in this fight than Roc Nation. You think Roc Nation would have experience in this shit, man? They're like working social media. Jay-Z, you don't know how to work social media? Seriously? I don't understand it. They like writing checks there, though. Maybe they're doing the same thing Floyd's doing.
Yeah, I guess.
They like writing checks, but they don't like promoting.
I guess. We're all caught up now. Are you happy? Are you happy with being all caught up again?
Yeah, there's nothing on boxing scene.
We're all up to date. That's literally crazy. Down to the minute. I mean, the only thing that I've seen that's happened in the last few hours, actually, the current, because again, there is a possibility, the current odds for Floyd versus Connor on one website posted by BDA Boxing, which is pretty good. Floyd is only -1,000 and Connor's +600.
Could you imagine? What is Cal Brook and them really going to demand? $15 million? $12 million?
Nothing.
Like, Lee, these guys, yeah, this is like serious money for them already. Conor McGregor was talking about Pacquiao numbers. Floyd's going to be like, screw that. I'm gone. He's always wanted Wembley. He said it, right? He's now got the – it's set up for it to be an epic battle if Cal Brook can defeat Spence. This is epic, all right? It's epic in America. It's totally epic in the UK. This is huge. Floyd would go there. He'd be Muhammad Ali status. I'm dead serious. If Floyd could walk the streets the week of that fight, and every UK fan would be there walking with him. I think that fight is that big. Conor McGregor gets pushed to the side. Dana White knows it. Now he's trying to promote this thing. Now he's trying to tell us McGregor signed and Floyd's a big sissy. I get it. Don't believe it. There's other big fish, bigger fish in the boxing world for Floyd to take on than the sideshow.
Oh, I think this, I don't disagree with what you say and him watching the outcome of this fight before he actually puts his name onto a contract.
McGregor, but exactly.
Let's be honest. We all know Floyd's going to fight this year, and he's going to fight somebody. It's going to happen. And I still say Manny Pacquiao drawing a sellout in Australia helps his chances.
But Bob Arum says he owes it to his fans to give him Crawford Pacquiao. But it's Bob Arum who wants Manny to finish his career with Top Rank. He does not want that last defeat to be on someone else's promotional company. And that's, Manny knows it. They're gouging him, Lee. They keep asking for the same money this guy made 13, 14 years ago. And he's not the same fighter. But you guess what, Bob? If you want that last defeat, this is what it costs.
There you go. We've covered everything. That was a good day.
That was it.
That was good.
Happy job. Mother's Day to everybody's mama.
Happy Mother's Day to everybody. We'll be back on Sunday as scheduled, covering all the fighting that we talked about for this weekend for you guys to watch, both HBO and Showtime. Of course, check us out, Fight Net Radio, all one word. It'll take you right to iHeartRadio. Guess what? iHeartRadio works for both iPhones and Androids. So whichever way you want to listen to it, or if you're listening to this in the rooms, as I always say, share it, comment, and share. All you got to do, hit the share button. I'm not even asking you to like it. Hit the share button. It's not that hard. Hit the share button. It's the best boxing show with an opinion out there. It's also the longest running boxing show with an opinion out there. There you go. Enjoy. And both Andrew and I will see you next week.
Thank you for enduring another episode of Fight Net Radio. Fight Net Radio is available for download and subscription on iTunes. Or visit Fight Net Radio and tell us how offended you are by today's show. Thank you for listening.